Hey everyone, Mark Jones here with another episode of Motivational Work. For this week's episode, we're going to be talking about exposure. Before we get started, do me a favor, hit that notification button and also hit the subscribe button so that you can get this information as soon as we release it and when it premieres on our channel so that you have it as quickly as possible. We want to make sure that you get your motivational dose. For this week, we're going to be talking about exposure. Before we kind of get into our principles, I'm just going to give you a little bit of background why we chose this particular topic for this week. A few years ago in Columbus, I was involved with an organization called Purple Isle. So Purple Isle came in and we identified a few transportation areas that we can improve in the city and came up with some different ideas that would be innovative and kind of help the flow of public transportation in the city. One of the people that I met there, she was a city, urban, and regional planner. So with that being said, I asked her, what made you want to choose that career? Because it was something that I had never heard of before. She told me that her friend, a friend of her father, was a planner. So that's where she got that initial introduction to urban and regional planning. I thought that was an amazing thing that needed to be talked about. Coming from where I come from, you don't get a lot of exposure to a lot of different things. You kind of hear about the same career fields. So a lot of people will say, I'm going to school for criminal justice. You hear people say they're going to go to school to be a nurse, be a teacher, kind of like those general career fields, maybe be a police officer, a firefighter, and nothing's wrong with any of that. But exposure opens up new doors for you to kind of help you identify where you want to be. And that's kind of the first principle that we're going to talk about today. So identifying where you want to be in your career field, where you want to be if it's being an entrepreneur, if it's being whatever you want to be, identify that early. And if you can identify that early, that gives you time to research, that gives you time to figure out what the vehicle is going to be for you to get there. You may not need to go to college to achieve your goal of working in the police force. You may just be able to go to police academy and start that career field and go to school a little bit later and do some of the things that we talked about in our last episode, like taking advantage of tuition reimbursement, tuition assistance, and things of that sort. So if you're identifying where you want to be and you know what that vehicle is going to be for you to get there, then you have a better opportunity to succeed in your goals. Principle number two is identifying some individuals who are already doing what you want to do. If you can identify those individuals, that's going to help you kind of change the trajectory of where you're going in your career, because you'll surround yourself around those individuals that's already doing what you want to do. That is super important when you're out there and you're pursuing your goals. One of the things that I've been trying to do is get my clothing line off the ground, generate more traffic to my site, SEO, and things of that sort. So I didn't go and ask my family about how to do that. I reached out to a guy that I went to school with because he was already working kind of in that sector and had a lot of experience with custom t-shirts and kind of starting the websites and what websites he was using, what materials he was using, where he was sourcing his shirts from. And that gave me the exposure to be able to identify what I wanted to do in my clothing line. And I've taken a lot of that advice and it's been super beneficial because of the exposure to him and what he has already been able to foster in his current career path of being an entrepreneur as well. And the last principle that we're gonna talk about is changing your environment. So if you're wanting to get into that criminology field or you wanna get into the medical field, you need to surround yourself with individuals that are already there. So try to work in that field or somewhere close to it so that you can have exposure to what's going on there. And then you may identify that, hey, I don't even want to work in a medical field. This is a lot more challenging than I initially thought it would be. However, you will have the exposure and you won't waste tons of money and tons of time trying to identify if that's something that you actually want to do for a career field or a career path. If you want to be an entrepreneur and you just know that you want to get something started, then you'll be able to identify that as well. Work with some entrepreneurs, see what they're doing, kind of find what your niche is gonna be. You don't wanna just go out there and say, I'm gonna be an entrepreneur, start dibbling, dabbling in everything, because then you're gonna waste a lot of energy, you're gonna waste a lot of time. But at the end of the day, just ensure that you're doing whatever it takes for you to be able to be successful. So identify where you wanna be, figure out what your vehicle is to get there. Number two, identify some individuals that's already in that field that you wanna get into, and surround yourself with those individuals. Pick their brain. Ask them questions. The worst thing they can tell you is they don't have time right now. They may get back to you. They may not get back to you, but then you'll find other individuals who will be willing to share their experience and share their successes with you. And the third principle is identifying some job choices or ways to identify, to put yourself in that environment, the environment that you want to be in. If it's an entrepreneurial environment, if it's a professional environment, get involved. Get involved in some organizations that's related to the field that you want to be in. And if you do that, you will definitely be successful. But one of the things I wanted to leave you with today is one of the mantras that I gained when I was playing football back in high school. One of my coaches told me, it's mind over matter. What does that really mean, mind over matter? I don't mind because it doesn't matter, right? I don't mind because it doesn't matter. What you're going through in this current moment, it may be stressful, it may be hard, it may be challenging, but those minimal times, those temporary things that you're going through, they don't matter in the grand scheme of things. You gotta work hard, go the extra mile, give it a little bit more than you may wanna give it, but when you get to the finish line, it'll be all worth it in the end. I don't mind because it doesn't matter. So if you're in the gym and you're trying to lose weight and you wanna follow through with that 2021 resolution, remember it. You don't mind because it doesn't matter. You sacrificing changing your diet, it doesn't matter because you have an end goal in mind. Keep that on your mind this week as we progress through. Keep those three principles as we progress through and make sure that you are focusing on your dreams. You can do it. Don't let naysayers tell you that you can't just because they couldn't, right? You can do it if you put your mind to it. And remember, you don't mind because it's temporary pain, this temporary pressure, this temporary challenge doesn't matter. It's your boy Motivational Mark signing out. And before I leave, do me a favor, hit that subscribe button, hit the notification button so that you can make sure that you get the videos as soon as they premiere and as soon as we release them on our channel. I look forward to chatting with you guys next week. Do me a favor, drop some comments down there on some challenging things that you're going through this week or what you would like us to talk about next week in the next episode. I appreciate you coming to the channel. Thank you.